what we all missed out on. This is some good stuff, and I maybe I'll just play a little bit here, Jeff. You give me your initial thoughts, okay?
Sure.
Here's the unemployment choo-choo. All right, Jeff. We've gotten this issue fixed here. We were having a little audio trouble here, but we found some Stedman on Ellen talking about what makes his long relationship with Oprah work here. And I'd be curious to see if you would like to listen. I mean, would you be interested?
Oh, no, I would like to take a listen. I think that we have it pretty much figured out. I mean, he's just staying to stay at this point. But, yeah, so I would like to hear what
he says. I mean, are we both in agreement that we know he could do better?
We can take a look, take a listen, and know that, yes.
Okay, well, here's Stedman on Ellen, and here's a little quip about how much he loves Oprah. What do you think she's good at?
Well, she's a great cook. I mean, among other things, she loves to be able to go out and cook whatever she wants to cook. You know, it's kind of natural. It's a beautiful thing.
Right, but you were at a store buying some other stuff. Anyway, so, and we're going to get to the book. I want to talk about the book, but just real quickly with what's going on, you know, for a while there was a talk that Oprah was going to run for president. I know that she's not going to run, you know, but you think she would be a great president.
Oh, yes. No, you can trust her. No,
yeah. Okay, now hang on. He's getting ready to do a pitch about Oprah for president, and I feel like this is total bullshit. I don't think he means what he's about to say here, Jeff. What do you think?
No, I don't think so. He's probably, like, clenching his fists as he says it.
I bet you his sphincter is tight.
He doesn't want to be at the White House. He doesn't want to be on Pennsylvania Avenue. He just wants a clean, happy, quiet life.
He's tired of being second fiddle to Oprah. Could you imagine being second man? I mean, anyway, this is what he thinks about Oprah and being the president.
She's smart.
Yeah.
She has a photographic memory.
Mm-hmm.
She works very, very hard. And so she has qualifications to do it, and she's very successful.
Right. Okay, so let's talk about identity leadership. Explain what that
is
to everyone.
Wow, Ellen blew that right off.
Right off.
She moved on quickly from that, huh?
I got to tell you, you know why? Because everyone's waiting in the audience for him to talk about identity leadership. Okay. All right, so this is just a little clip for all of you who are like, I want to hear about identity leadership.
It's based on the philosophy that you can't lead anybody else until you first lead yourself. So it really is focused on self-mastery, self-efficacy, self-empowerment. You know, it's the greatest thing I discovered for myself to be able to work on myself so I can define myself as opposed to having the world define me.
Right. And so how would you say you do that? Because basically you're talking about self-confidence, that you don't let somebody else veer your opinion.
I got to tell you.
Someone else put you in the box.
I got to tell you, before we go any further, I mean, he is a lively interview.
Yeah, he sounds with it.
He doesn't sound like, you know, your average motivational speaker. I got to tell you, he's really motivating me with his leadership.
Is he? Okay.
And
here's the problem to me, and let's just be honest, you're trying here. She has him drunk. And he certainly sounds like...
Wait, do you think she's got him on the opiates?
I think he's oped.
You think Oped him? You think Ope put him on some oxys?
And I don't think that he's even in control of his own bowel movements at this point. That's
kind of
what it sounds like.
Well, see, let's see. I'm not ready to say that yet. She's saying, here's your pitch. You're on national TV. What's he saying about leadership? Let's see.
What happens when you can't define yourself, the world defines you by your race. It defines you by your house, your car, your money, your title. It defines you by your gender and tells you you can't make it because it's a man's world. And it's kind of socially constructed and designed to control your own development.
Mm-hmm.
And so I created this process that starts with identity as the foundation for organizing your growth. You know, it allows you to shape your own future. It allows you to understand your talents, your skills, your abilities, and your purpose. Mm-hmm. So everything starts with a purpose.
Yep.
And then you have to create a vision for yourself to basically organize a vision that's bigger than your circumstances, and then you organize a plan. So there's a step-by-step process for self-actualization.
So
Wow. Yeah, he's perked. He's perked. His eyes are closed.
Now we know what she's doing. She's hitting him with the Michael Jackson.
I was just going to say, she's fucking propofoling him at night. He's drinking his milk.
Oops, open him.
Here's the unemployment choo-choo. All right, Jeff, just to wrap up here, this unemployment choo-choo, we were going to talk about something else, but I really do want to delve into... I'm a little hurt that we've made this discovery about Stedman.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about up there. Okay, I really feel that he's a marionette.
He's a drug mule.
He's a marionette at this point, and she has him on opioids. I think we have it all figured out.
He
erratically does things like when she kicked him out of the house, and he's just wandering around by himself and. Very, very strange.
Are you familiar with David Miscavige, the head of the Church of Scientology?
No, I don't know well, but I know there's one in Clearwater, Florida, and I lived down by that way.
So. Well, David Miscavige is the head of the Church of Scientology. David Miscavige's wife has been not seen in public and missing since 1999. Now, a lot of people say he's got her locked up in a cage. They haven't been able to find her. Do you think that these very sporadic, monotone, drug-fueled interviews is a way for Oprah to show, or at least put the facade out there, that Stedman's around, he's alive, and he's okay, but realistically just send him out with a new stupid-ass book every couple years?
She sends him with a stupid book.
Yep.
And she has him monotone, all right? She pills up his rice cakes.
Right.
That's all he gets to eat.
Right.
So she's got his rice cakes pilled up, and he goes out there, and he's talking, and people are going, this is the guy. This is it. Then she comes, with full of life and vigor, and he's just sitting there flarping and glarping.
Well, I got to tell you, I have very rarely seen Ellen DeGeneres bored. But I got to tell you, Ellen is fucking bored, this interview. It's 4 minutes and 20 seconds, and Ellen is sleepy.
Yeah, she left, put a snuggie on, and came back.
Okay, Ellen finished this interview in slippers with a hot cocoa.
No, she left. The audience exited, and he was still going.
Okay, this is after this is his now. Listen, she says, "You have any final thoughts?" All right, and this is Stedman's final thoughts, and I want you to hear. He goes on for about 25 seconds, and then Ellen tries to wrap it up, and you can just tell that she has not engaged with him at all.
She hasn't even sneezed, nothing.
She might be pilled up herself at this point. All right, but here's Stedman's final word about, leadership. And an identity and his passport to success.
Okay.
Teach that process all around the world to anyone so they can take information and make it relevant to their development in the 24 hours that they have every single day, which
yep.
is what makes us all equal. Everybody else 24 hours.
Right.
So the question has become, what do you do with
First off, time? Before we go any further, do you hear her rushing them off? Do you hear her rushing them off? And do you hear the audience in the background? They're coughing. Nobody's saying anything. Nobody's reacting.
I feel bad for the man.
I do too. See, she puts him. All right, hold on. Here's his final words here.
How are you able to maximize your potential based on who you are as a person?
Yep. And as you said, we all have 24 hours. It's just, what we all do with it. Stedman's book is called Identity Leadership. It's available now, and you're all going home with a copy, and we'll be right back.
Whoa. I'll tell you what. That audience really woke up when they all were going home with a copy.
Because they knew they were going home. It was over.
Yay! You're right. You would think it. No, they're just. He's like, oh, I think they liked my book. Nah, dog.
You could be sitting there launching Molotov cocktails at the man, and he wouldn't flinch from the script. He's so doped up.
That's what I. It's so sad. Do you see? We've discovered that he's doped up. And I'll, you know what? Just for shits and giggles, let's just one more time. I want to hear. So she's promoting the book. Is this a promotion of the book, or is this they're happy that it's over? All right, hang on. Hang on here. All right, here we go, guys. Last 15 seconds.
Your potential based on who you are as a person.
Yep. And as you yep. said, we all have 24 hours. It's just, you know, what we all do with it. Stedman's book is called Identity Leadership. It's available now, and you're all going home with a copy, and we'll be right back.
I think that's a yay that this is over.
I think that his book just became fire logs for people's fire. Jesus God. He was oped by Oped.
Unemployment. Choo-choo.